Hello! Kain tayo! That's brown rice. No? Brown rice. Ito yung mansi. Nasaan yung camera ko? Ito yung mansi. Ah, this is my? A large saltwater crocodile swims out to sea. Its territory has been seen as set for an encounter between two of the world's mightiest predators. The shark sends its prey, goes to investigate, and it finds food, but this one
finds the barrel.
Ah. Chillax lang ang ating kain ngayon, guys.
The crocodile can't get a good grip.
Chillax.
The shark makes a wide turn to come by for a full set of assaults.
They hold both creatures while they take the egg from the nest. Another hungry crocodile tries to sneak into a nest to get some eggs, but he comes face to face with the lizard and gets his nose bitten. The fight is quick and snappy, but both animals survived. Watching this mother's son trying to get to this crocodile's eggs must have been such a privilege for the people. All lookers spent days hoping the monitor lizard would succeed, or that the crocodile mom would catch the thief. I guess they were hoping for some action.
What's the matter, babe? I don't know.
The man did not know if the crocodile killed a badger, as it was already dead, probably for a day or two.
The honey badger is bringing a little crocodile killed back to its home base to feast on. Early lunch ako kasi mag-exercise.
Eventually, honey badger loses interest and walks away, leaving a few bite marks on the crocodile, which is still wondering what that crazy animal was.
5. Crocodile versus dog. Sometimes, size doesn't matter, and this small dog proves it when it chases an alligator back into the water without an ounce of fear. These two dogs are standing on the edge of death, and when death arrives, one of the dogs is snatched and taken back into the water to meet the Grim Reaper in person. Some people were down south testing out some new models of knives for deep sea fishing. The captain of the boat saw an eight-foot alligator jump 4 feet out of the water to grab his dog by the nose right off the dock. Thankfully, the dog was able to escape back to safety and just had a few scratches on his nose. He is now a little more cautious about what's floating around the boat. No kidding. Crocodile versus buffalo. A buffalo can be seen trying to escape the grip of a hungry crocodile as it comes running out of the water with the crocodile latched onto the buffalo's leg. Another buffalo tries to help his friend by tossing the crocodile into the air twice, roaring it in the process. The buffalo got away with seemingly mild injuries, but it didn't look too good for the crocodile. When a crocodile latches onto a buffalo's neck, the mighty buffalo retreats with so much power that the crocodile panicked, forcing its leg go.
Ben?
The buffalo in this video seems to have no idea what is going on in the water, but he finds out soon enough when a nasty crocodile pops out of the water to try and bite its head off. Luckily for the buffalo, the reptile misses, which gives the buffalo the opportunity to walk away without any injury. 3. Crocodile versus wildebeest.
it out.
When one of the hippos charges the crocodile, the wildebeest can free itself and walk away. To keep this wildebeest from leaving the water, this crocodile is holding onto its tail, but it isn't enough to keep the wildebeest submerged. The crocodile eventually abandons the hunt, but the damage is already done because the wildebeest has a broken leg and cannot get back up. This wildebeest is bound to be attacked and eaten by another predator sooner than later. While crossing the river at the side bar, the wildebeest was snatched by a large Nile crocodile.
Le están figurando el juego. De Nile. Super bang. Ini dah tentu tiru si pape. Stop looking for my full size style. I said it's pork. I call her guilty because he's pricky. Oh, pricky. That's from the lightning. Now I'm saying it was a little bit. Naponder. Naponder. You want more? That was a mukbang in the house. More. One is that the sons of God is a reference to the godly line of Seth. What is the kind of thing? Adam and Eve had relations, and Seth was born, and Seth carried on the godly faith of Abel. So one idea is that the sons of God are the descendants of Seth, marrying the daughters of men, the ungodly line of Cain. Second interpretation is that the sons of God refers to men, angels, and non-beings, intermarrying with humans. The third idea is that the sons of God are heroes from the mythical
past, pirate kings. We have stories from the ancient Greece, for example. We have stories from the
first time. Lalo si Papa Bing. Kailangan iwan si Papa.
So, how do we find the right interpretation? The exact expression, sons of God, only occurs 4 or 5 times in the Hebrew Bible. We have one occurrence here in Genesis 6. We have two occurrences in the introduction.
Lana, what's happening now?
One looked like the Son of God, which would mean a divine being, an angelic. There are only 5 occurrences in the entire Bible where we have the exact expression Son of God or Son of God. And it always refers to angelic beings. We must distinguish this use from other places. There are other places in the Bible where they indicate that the relationship of a human to God is like a father-son relationship. So, Adam and God have a father-son relationship.